purposes in the deal. One was, you're right, it could be used for caution.
Knowledge in our business is everything, but I'm not doing this stuff. This guy is.
And the other, it could be used for chemicals and pesticides.
Really?
Yeah, that's one extreme to the other.
It is one extreme to the other. Yeah, they asked a lot of questions because they wanted to learn. And you know, that's the whole idea of my wine museum. I wanted to teach people about what these things were.
Does this have anything to do with wine?
Well, it doesn't, as much as it went out into fields, and fields were.
Okay, I see what you're saying.
For anybody that has a coffee shop or an amazing elaborate large kitchen, they would love to have something like this. Came out of Napa Valley and said, would you be willing to let go of this? I think I want to let that go.
$700.
Alright.
I'll do that.
The museum is probably not gonna happen, but what Jim did do was preserve all of this history.
Now, where'd you do this, Kentucky?
Actually, it came right out of Petaluma.
Really?
Because we're so close to the bay.
What was that piece of this? What's this?
This was used in the process of making brandy.
Okay. How much are these two pieces we got on the?
You know what, if you don't mind, I can just double check my books. Probably in my book.
Of course, of course.
Hey, let me just go over to the books. This is one of five books that's cataloged for the contributing stories of the class.
Thank you. This is how I get up, get ready for the morning, so peace. Sorry I'm not talking very well, so in this video. Okay, love you.